As the scripture had said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. I'm not going to preach tonight because I'm going to save my preaching till Sunday. But I don't know where we're going, but we are going somewhere. As I sat here on Monday night as we were preparing for prayer, we were only just going to have prayer on Monday and Wednesday night. But as I sat there folding the cloths, the Lord spoke and said, worship and intercession. He said, worship and intercession. Come go with me. Don't hold your mouth. Come go with me. He said, worship and intercession. And what he declared by that is he had me to put worship before intercession. Because he said, they that worship me must worship me in spirit and in truth. And before you can pray to God, before you can pray to God, thank you, Brother Doug, I know you got to go to work. Before you can pray to God, he must reveal his truth to you. He must reveal his truth to you, because if you don't know truth, you don't know what to pray. If you don't know truth, you don't know what to pray. But it is in your worship, it is in your consecration, it is in your time with God, because worship is not a slow song. Worship is, say amen. Worship is not a slow song, but it's your dedication and your time spent with God. And God said, in your worship, in your time spent, in your consecration, in your dedication, I'm going to reveal to you my truth. He said, and after that it is that I deal with you with my truth. He said, now you're ready to intercede. Because before truth comes, you're praying for stuff. You're praying for cars. You're praying for houses. You're praying for money. You're praying for all of these things. But God said that this is not what I want you to pray. He said, this is not what I want you to pray. He said, because the Bible says in Matthew 6 and 33 that if you first seek ye the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness, I told you, he who hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be filled. But he said, if you first seek the kingdom of heaven and all of his righteousness, he said, then all of these things. You pray for things, and God said, don't pray for things, pray for me. Tell your neighbor, stop praying for stuff and pray for God. Because when it is that you pray for God and you get him, you'll get the stuff. Because he said it in his word that in my presence there is fullness of joy. And there's pleasures on his right hand forevermore. So when I get into the place that he wants me to be in, he'll get me the pleasures. He'll get me the stuff that I need. He'll get me the money that I desire. But he said, but it's not until you tap into my truth that you'll get what it is that I have for you. But he said, but if any man thirst is not just I need something to drink, but thirst is not just I want something to drink, but thirst is a mixture of not only do I want it, but I need it. And he said, any man thirst after me, meaning that he's pursuing me. If you thirsty, you're going to go looking in the refrigerator. If the refrigerator don't open, you're going to open it because you're looking for something. And God is asking us tonight, who's looking for me? Because if you search for me with all your heart, I'll find you. You won't have to find me.
Come on, Pastor. Amen.
I'm talking whether y'all know it.
Amen.
But he said, if you search for me, not will you find me, but I'll find you. Not because of you, but because of your search.
My
not because of you, but because of your thirst.
My God.
Because of your thirst. So God says tonight, he says, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. And we can cut the air up just a little bit. Let him come unto me and drink. But then he goes on to say, he that believeth on me, not in me. And these are Jesus' words. He said, he that believeth on me, as the scripture has said. See, the thing that you got to know, that's why we're in this time of prayer and fasting. And not only that, but we're in consecration. Because, see, I can pray and fast, but not step away from some stuff.
Tell the truth.
We can pray and fast, but it's your consecration that it is that God is concerned about. Because I can give up a plate, but still be messy. I can stop drinking, but still have a hint of lying in me. But God says, not only do I want you to give it up, but I want you to walk away. So he said, if you believe on me, as the scripture has said. And so it's time for us now here that we know the truth of what God is saying. He said, as the scripture has said, out of his belly, and I'm moving to a hasty close. He said, out of his belly shall flow. Meaning that it might not flow, but he said it shall flow. That's not a if it'll flow, but it shall flow. That's a command. That's some dedication to his word to know that it shall flow, but you must believe not in me, mother, but on me. He said, I don't need you not just to believe in me. He said, but believe on me. Now I hear some baptism going on. Because when you're baptized, you're not just baptized on the inside, but you're baptized on me. The water, the spirit don't just get in you, but it got to get on you.
That's right.
Because between you and your flesh, what's in you may not make it on the outside. So he says, now what's on you got to match what's in you. He said, if any man be in Christ, he didn't say anything about Christ being in you. But he said, if any man be in Christ.
Right. Okay.
He said, if you abide in my word. We got to get in him. I believe we're in him now.
Amen. Yes.
We're in him now.
Yes.
So now that we're in him, we get to the scripture. I'm closing. He said, he that believeth on me, as the scripture has said.
That way.
Yes.
Come on.
Not on your way, but he said, as my scripture, it's already told to you how to believe on me. He said, out of his belly, out of the person's belly that believe on me, he said, shall flow rivers of living water.
Right.
That simply means that it's not just going to run one time.
All right.
But he said, there's going to be a continuous movement because anything that stops starts to get stale.
Right.
Tell somebody around you, anything that stops starts to get stale. If you sit water around for so long, it's going to start to stink. Not because of what's in it, but because of the environment it's in. That's why it's important to know what you're in.
Come on.
So he said, he that believeth on me, as the scripture said, out of his belly shall flow. Meaning that it's going to be continuous. Not you come to church one time, get what you need, and then the next time we got to pull you. Because that means the river stopped flowing. It don't mean that when you get what you need from God, you don't go back to God because you got what you need. But he said, it's going to flow out of his belly because it's one thing to have it in your chest. It's one thing to have it in your toe. But it's another thing for it to get in your belly. And that's why when things start to happen and people get sepsis, it means that it gets down on the inside of their belly.
Yeah.
And if not careful, it'll cause you to die. It'll cause you to die. And so he says, but for you that believe on me, he said, I'm going to cause your insides not to become stale.
I'm going to cause your insides not to begin to stink. He said, but I'm going to cause something to happen. And what's going to happen is that you're going to have rivers, not just one river. You're not just going to have one river, but the Bible says that there shall be rivers, meaning whatever need I have on this side, God's going to flow to it. Whatever need I have on that side, God's going to flow to it. Because rivers of living water are going to flow.
Thank you, Jesus.
Rivers of living water. And so, as I come to a close, the Bible says that there are going to be rivers of living water. Shoes, please. They're going to flow. They're going to flow. And so tonight, we've made it through the first half.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, yes,
yes.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
We made it through the first half.
Yes, Lord.
God is saying that I'm getting ready to cause things to flow out of you.
Hallelujah.
I'm getting ready to cause things to flow out of you.
Yes, Lord.
That's a good place. Getting ready to cause things to flow out of you. And some of you have had needs. Some of you have had lacks. Some of you have had desires. Some of you have had wants. But God is saying that He's preparing to cause it to flow out of you. He's going to cause it to flow out of you. What you're looking for, God said, I've already invested it on the inside of you. But once you walk in my truth, I'm going to release what it is that you need, and it's going to come out of you.
Amen.
It's going to come out of you. It's going to come out of you. Tonight, I'm going to pray with you. I'm going to pray for you. Because God wants to activate the rivers that you have on the inside of you. Going to activate what's inside of you. They come. You might have to work tonight. God said power is being restored. have spectators around here. We have participators.
Amen.
Power is being restored.
Power, yes.
Rivers.
Thank you.
you, and you don't know me. But God's gonna do something for you. And you may not even understand what I'm saying, but I'm putting it in the air. God's gonna do something for you. And it ain't even because of you, but it's just because of who you connected to back then. Sister Stacy, come here. Who told you to wear blue? Put your hands in her hands. Is it your mom? Who is it? Your granddad? Mm-hmm. But I heard God say, come here, Lady Shane.
Hail it, Pastor. Hail it. Hail it. Hail it, Pastor.
She's going to touch your hands. And when you go home, you lay hands on when you see your granddaddy again.
Thank you.
Y'all ain't moving fast enough. Mother Andrews, lay your hands on his chest. And God said, somebody shout, God said. It was interesting that you talked to me this morning. Lift your hands. And God said this time, the devil fight you because he thinks he took mama early. And God said, ever since he's been fighting you in your heart.
Just a minute to interrupt the service just to thank God for what he
through fire. There's a new fire. and just shout, do it.
Do it. Do it.
I'm closing. He's going to baptize you, and he's going to give you evidence. They're gonna be rivers. Somebody just shout, more of God.
More
God. I heard him say somewhere between communion and dismissal. I won't say something gonna hit you. I'm gonna say he gonna hit you. And out of your belly, shall flow rivers. You believe? And if you believe on me, that's the scripture that says. Is there anybody that's been baptized that can agree with her? That say, because I believe that if God did it for me, if you ask him for it. Thank you. is so.
Thank you.
anything. And if everybody, come on, give me that sound. Yeah. Yeah.
The fact that you've been giving things up for the more of God
He honors that. And so he's going to give you back something in return, because you can't beat his giving.
Amen.
And the more you give up, the more he'll give back to you. And so we're all standing. We're all standing. We could just lift the verse of that up one time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
But never your presence, that you would lead us and guide us, step beside us, Father, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for what you've done in our midst. And God, we thank you for just being God. God, we thank you for pouring out your spirit upon all flesh, in the name of Jesus. And God, as we return back to our various destinations, God, we pray that you would stop any incidents, any accidents, any untimely deaths. We bind them now in the name of Jesus. Oh God, say in the blood of Jesus be against you, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for our coming here, and we thank you for our leaving. And God, as we prepare to return back to this place on Sunday, let us return without the loss of one. Continue to give us a high time in you. Let your glory fill this place. Let your glory fill this place. In the name of Jesus, oh God, we thank you and we praise you. We give you glory, we give you honor. We want none and we take none, but we give it all to you. It is in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Go in peace.
What's up, you guys? It's your girl, Sheila. Frank. Come on over and check out our channel, PromoSTK Reality TV, husband and wife, where we eat good in the neighborhood. We're a mukbang eating show, cooking and recipes, especially soul food, pranks on Frank. Oh, y'all go check it out. Challenges, vlogs, comedy skits, short videos, and TikTok. So come on and become our baby today. Subscribe to our channel. Follow us on Instagram, PromoSTK, PromoSTK, or you can also go to any of our social sites and find us under PromoSTK. Baby. We can't wait to see you. We can't wait to meet you. So come on over.